Hello, my name is rayodaniel, and I want to welcome you to my channel. In this video, we're going to continue our high-level video series on features of Highlevel. Specifically, we're going to be talking about the website chat widget. Now, before we get started, if you have not subscribed to the channel, please click on the subscribe button, click on the like button on this video if you find it useful. I really do appreciate it helping me grow my channel. Also, if you are interested in Highlevel, please use my affiliate link below. I do get credit for it, and I thank you so much in advance. So let's get started. So here we are at our demo account. Let me pop back over here real quick. This is our demo account inside of Highlevel. And right now, this is our sort of demo website that we've got set up. Now, what I want to show you is what the website chat widget looks like and talk a little bit about it first before we look at its configuration. So down here in the bottom right-hand corner is where you'll see the website chat widget. And it's just a simple little blue button. You've probably seen this on a lot of different sites, but this one's available through Highlevel and it's very customizable. But right now, the button basically just says, "Hi there, are you looking to book an appointment? Text us here." So right now, I'm going to kind of step through this. I don't want to fill this out quite yet. I want to hop back over and show you some of the initial setup and how we got there. So on the main demo account, if you go under the sites area, this sites area has a bunch of different information about funnels, websites, blogs, all this information where you might use a website chat widget, but we're not going to cover those features in this video. I do have other videos on my channel that covers the funnels, websites, and blogs. Go take a look at that and hopefully you'll find those useful as well. Right now, what we're going to do is go over here to the chat widget and look at how we can get it customized. So first of all, just right off the bat here, I want to show you that there's a nice little preview pane on the right-hand side of the screen that shows you what it would look like once you turn these features on and off and what the text would look like and so forth. So it's really nice giving a preview so we don't need to worry about having to go back to your website and look and so forth. So right now, this chat bubble is this little white area that you see right here. So we can turn that off and not have a chat bubble. That little blue button, sometimes people would recognize it, but oftentimes I really like to keep the chat bubble on. I think it's very useful. It gets people's attention and really is engaging. Now, the whole point of the website chat widget is when somebody goes to your website, whether they find you online through Google Maps or through Apple Maps, regardless, when they go to your website, you want them to engage with you in a real-time situation. Oftentimes when they try to call you, you may not be available depending upon your business, but you can have this website chat widget that people can click on, submit their information, and get and begin a text conversation is what happens between you and whoever is responding to this particular widget. Excuse me. So right now, moving on here, you have an intro message, which is this message that appears here in the bubble. Just kind of write whatever business you're in. "Hi, this is the carpet cleaning company. Are you looking to get your carpets cleaned? Text us here." Something like that. All you're trying to do is get the customer engaged with this. Now, the next thing we do is we have an avatar image, which is this little customizable image that we see here. If you want to leave the default, there's a nice picture of a lady on here that's very attractive. So you can just simply leave that picture on there if you want. Or if people are used to doing business with you, you can simply just put your own photograph up in here, a nice little headshot, or just put your company logo, which is what I have here. This is a company logo. Just simply upload a picture. You can click on edit image, upload it from your computer, and then bam, it's on there. And that's what you see throughout the entire interaction with this website chat widget. Now, the next thing is for an area for returning visitors. Here's important. Let's just say somebody comes to your website initially. They click on the website chat widget and they fill it out, which we're going to do here in just a minute or so. So they fill it out, and then let's just say they don't do anything. They close it and they come back to your website. Well, you don't want them to get the same screen before because they've already filled out the information. Now you can customize it because they've already given you their name and whatever information that you're looking for. Excuse me. So right now you can have a custom message for them. And here's where you can put that in there. You could say by default, it says welcome back name. It has the name field, which it puts their name in there. Are you looking to book another appointment? So now you can have a more personalized message for that person when they come to your website to follow up again. Very nice feature. So this is just the initial upfront what it looks like. Now what I want to do here is go back to the main screen. To the demo site and actually click on this bubble. So now that you click on the bubble, now the form pops up that allows them to fill it out to begin interacting with you. So I'm going to pause here and I'm going to go back to the demo account and look at the widget screen here, which is the customization that you get once somebody engages, it clicks on the bubble and opens up the form. So notice we have a header. It just says have a question. I've left the default, which appears at the top. Here's this little picture of the lady. This is sort of a default image that you get. Now that image won't be used because you've already uploaded the image for the avatar in the previous screen. So that image will always be used throughout it here. But this is just kind of what it would look like. You have an intro message, what you want to have displayed at the top. All of it can be customized. Now here's a nice field. Right now, by default, just the name, mobile phone number, and the message is all that you comes by default. Now you can actually ask for the person's email, but for the purposes of using the website chat widget, their phone number is all that you need, because when utilizing the chat widget, you're actually creating a text conversation between them and you through your website. So the phone number is really the only thing that they need to continue with that SMS. But if you do want to ask for the email address field, you can just simply enable that here. The email then pops up and you can collect the email address. Now, it's not required, but if they do fill it out, then your contact record, which we're going to take a look at here, will be updated to include their email. So for these purposes, I'm just going to turn that off. Now, the legal message is this sort of little message that you see right here above the send button. I'm going to read that to you. It says, by submitting, you agree to receive SMS or emails for the provided channel rates may be applied. So all this means is that if you're going to fill out this form, this is sort of an FCC regulation that you're just letting the person know that if you want to submit this, then I have the right to text you back and you may be charged for that text message. So that's all it is just sort of a regulatory response. Now, the widget color, notice this blue up in here and the blue for the button. That can be changed. So it's nice, you can customize it to your own brand colors. Just simply enter the hex code in here and everything is, you can customize it to your liking. So right now I'm just gonna leave it blue for this demonstration. And then finally, one of the things that you can do is actually have this feature turned on. Now, this is if, for instance, you're a marketing agency and you're having your clients use this feature on their website, you can actually advertise your agency on their chat widget. You can turn this feature on, and now you get this powered by feature here at the very bottom. You can put in whatever you want and direct it to whatever website that you want, but we're not gonna do that here. We're gonna turn that off. So right now, that's all that we've got. I'm gonna pause on this screen, and then we're gonna go back to the live screen and show you what this looks like. So right now, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to simply type in a name, John Smith. I know, very original. Right now, I'm going to put in a phone number, 212-555-0000. Just kind of put a fake number in there. And the message, how much are your massages? Just something very simple. Again, this is a massage therapist, med spa site, so somebody could very well ask, how much are your massages? So here, we're not actually going to be able to demonstrate a two-way on this because I'm not using a real number for this, but you'll be enough to kind of get the point here. So right now, when we do this, we're going to simply click send. Now this is sending. Now we get this nice little message. Thank you. One of our representatives will contact you shortly. Let's go take a look at where you configure that. So here in the chat widget, we're going to go down under the acknowledgement settings. And we're going to open this up and we see this is where you can provide the thank you. You can provide a customer support contact, an email address, or maybe a phone number that they can call for support if that's what you're looking to use this for. The greeting, you could say thank you. You can get more descriptive if you want to. Customize that, and then the acknowledgement message. So this is really what you're going to get and how you can customize the website chat widget. Now, the next thing I want to do is, now that we've gone through how to customize it, what I want to do is pop in, notice that we've submitted this information, I want to pop in over here to the Highlevel CRM feature. Now, if you're interested in the CRM, there's another video on my channel that covers that, but if you click on the contacts area for this, now you will see here at the top, you will see a John Smith here loaded at the top, and it will actually have their phone number here, and right now, if we want to click this open and take a look at it here, we'll see the message that they got, how much are your massages, That's the message that came in. If you wanted to, you can just simply click on SMS at the bottom here, type a reply message, click send, and then you can send them back a message directly from the website. Or more importantly, Highlevel has a mobile app. It's called Lead Connector that you can download. That mobile app will pop up and give you a notification that somebody sent you a message. You can reply to them directly on your mobile device. So that's a great feature there. Now what I want to do is hop in and look at the website. Now the website for this particular demo account is actually configured inside of Highlevel. Now doing so makes it very easy to enable the chat widget. And I'm going to show you what that looks like here. So there's really two, let me back up just a minute. There's two ways of setting up your website. Number one, you can have it built inside of Highlevel, which makes it very seamless and easy to turn this on. The second, you can have an external site. And right now, if you do have an external site, I'm going to cover how you do that shortly after I get to this. But let's just see if your website is configured through Highlevel. Here's how you would turn that on. You would just simply go into the website, click on the settings area, and right here in the bottom, you would just simply see chat widget, enable or disable. So right here, you would just simply turn this on or turn it off. That's how easy it is to do that. Now, right now, I'm going to turn it off and I'm going to click save. Now I'm going to come back here to our live site and do a refresh, and then notice that that website widget goes away. You do not see it in the bottom right corner anymore. It's really just that simple. If you come back over here to settings, I'm going to turn it back on because I like having it on. Save the settings, come back over here, refresh it, and then the website chat widget pops back on the site again. So it's just taking a bit to load. Alrighty, so right now you kind of get the point here. I'm going to just move on. The next thing I want to show you is if you have a website outside of Highlevel, most commonly it's going to be on WordPress since that's the foremost leader of website software. I'm going to go back into the chat widget setting here, and I'm going to go right up here at the top. It says get it for WordPress, and there's a code button here. If you click on get code, you'll see that there's a little bit of code. You don't have to understand what this is. Okay, you don't. All you have to do is just simply click on the copy code button. It's copied. Now here, if you take a look, I'm going to try to blow this up. Copy this code in the body or footer section of your website. So what you would end up doing is, if you're not a tech person, you would take this code and email it to your website administrator, your webmaster, whatever you want to call it, the person that deals with your website. Or if it's you, you would just simply go into your site, go to the body area. There's typically a section under WordPress for the body header or a footer area, and just simply paste that code. That's all you need to do. Now, once you copy the code, you save it, and now the website widget will work. Anytime there's any interaction on that WordPress site or whatever site you're using, you will get the information back into Highlevel. It will store that information in Highlevel, and then you can begin having a conversation from there. Now, the only thing I want to make sure that you understand, if you ever sit back and go inside this area and customize any of this stuff again, if you change the intro message, if you change the return visitor, the image, anything like that, the colors, you have to go back in and redo that exercise again. You have to go back through and copy the code and then update the website chat widget on the remote site. Now, if you have the site inside of Highlevel, you don't need to do anything. As soon as you make the changes, the code, all you did is just enable the website chat widget within Highlevel. All of those new changes are automatic, nothing you need to do. But if you do have an external site, you will need to make sure you update the chat widget. Otherwise, it'll still have the old settings on it. So that's just something to keep in mind. Other than that, that's what we've got here for the website chat widget. Hopefully, if you found this video useful. Again, if you do, please click on the subscribe, like on the channel. If not, just have a great day and thank you so much. Hey, I want to thank you again for visiting my channel and give you one more little thing here. If you are interested in Highlevel and getting some additional Highlevel training, please see the link in the description below. I do have a free course I'm offering that covers everything related to Highlevel and gives you all the information that you need to know. Thank you so much and have a great day.